Hey everybody, this is a special Hawaii Bowl video. Thanks to Sadie and Paul and Carter for getting everything set up. Thanks to Dr. Geis for letting us use this room. And mostly thank you for watching and for supporting the Bulldogs against Hawaii in the Aloha Bowl Saturday at 9:30. We're out taking time out of their busy schedules. Coach Robert McFarland, and then Coy is the son of the father. Have you ever been to Hawaii?
I have not.
Okay. You been, Coach?
Yes, I have.
Okay. Yeah. Give people, when you try to tell Coy what it's going to be like.
Well, we went, my wife and I, you know, when you get married young in this business, yeah, you don't have a whole lot of money. So that was really our first truly official honeymoon. So it was our 10-year anniversary.
You're romantic.
I know, that's just me. But
Boy, he's got it.
So for our 10-year anniversary, Pam and I went. So we spent a week out there. And she felt claustrophobic for a whole week. Was worried where the kids were the whole time. So we did. We enjoyed it. It was a beautiful island and got to experience all the sights that you want to see on Oahu. And then we actually went over and spent a few nights on Kauai. So beautiful island.
I was at home.
Of course you were. yeah, they didn't want to take you. It's a romantic getaway. Hey, but you're getting to go this time.
I am. I'm excited.
Have a great day. Great birthday day.
Hey, we're going to Hawaii.
Sun's shining. We're going to Hawaii tomorrow. It's going to be an unbelievable day.
And your responsibilities, we know the Coach McFarland coaches offensive line, had the chance to visit with him on a number of occasions. What are your responsibilities mainly? I know it's to do whatever you're told.
Exactly. Do whatever I'm told from Coach Baker. I work with Coach Baker. I'm in the box on game days. I have the responsibility of giving him the personnel and formations. And then anything I see back end wise, if we're messing up at the safety position, I make sure I let him know because he's worried about the whole thing. I'm making sure that the back end, the DBs are where they need to be.
He looked back too soon, Coach. Line up. He looked back too soon. You looked back too soon.
You're out of bounds.
I was out of bounds, but you can't look back too soon.
And then during the week, graduate assistants are basically, you have certain responsibilities, but it could be that any coach at any time can tell you to do something.
Absolutely.
And you're basically his boy.
Absolutely. We don't say no. We say yes to everything, and anything the coaches need is our priority.
There's four of y'all, and thanks for working so hard. It's a lot harder than it looks. They just see y'all on game days with the headphones on, looking like you're having fun.
Here we go. Starting again.
Spin. Ball.
Give us, Coach McFarland, please, this Christmas time, so births are big. What are the circumstances surrounding Coy's birth as much as you can remember? Starting probably post-conception, just as his family program.
All right. Well, Coy was born on January 21st, right? Mm-hmm. But anyway, he was born on a recruiting weekend. Mm-hmm. And it was on a Saturday. And it happened to be a big weekend where I had a bunch of linemen in. And Pam decided that was the day. So while I was on a tour on campus with some players, she called. And fortunately, a friend of ours brought her to the hospital. Yeah, so I did leave the tour and went there and got to be there for Coy's birth. And went back, joined the tour, came back, and was checking on her and Coy. And then those 20-some people came over to the house. They called us periodically at the house to where were things hidden for the cookout and stuff. So they still had the cookout at our house that weekend.
He was your biggest signee that day, basically.
Yeah. Biggest one. Matter of fact, I think we signed everyone that was
there.
That's what I'm
about to ask. Did we get everybody?
Lucky charm. Miss Pam can't do that every. She can't do that every recruiting day.
No.
Watch your outside hand. Hey, don't bring it across your body. Keep the shoulder square. It's better. Don't overstride it. Good.
I've seen Coach irritated, and I've seen him overjoyed, and I've seen him frustrated, but I've never really seen him angry.
Yeah.
But I'm guessing, have you ever seen that?
It depends. If I ever missed curfew or if I did something really bad, if I ever got yelled at, I got the coaches talk. I never got the screamo at his lineman. If his lineman mess up, they get it way worse than I do.
Really?
No, way worse. But I got the lectures and the talking to's. I never got the major yell at.
All right, here we go. No, hey, get it off those shoulders. Bring it underneath. Hey, include your lats in the work.
Oh no, right behind him. Get to the ball, good.
Can you recall a time when you just wanted to that one?
You know, I think most of his time growing up, I was protecting him from his mother.
Yeah.
You know, so usually when I would come home, it was like, your son, come see what your son did. And,
she's one of the nicest people.
Oh, she is now. So I was kind of the piece trying to calm her down. And, I had to remind her whenever he got into Zorro as a young age that when he was scratching Z's in all the furniture, that 20 years later when she saw that Z etched in that wood, that she'd come to tears thinking about her little Zorro.
You went sentimental on her.
Inside out! Good. Good, Snead. Hey, great catch. Great catch, bad flip.
Boom, press, kick, right there. Here we go, on the ball, here we go.
You've probably lived 8 or 9 different places.
I have.
Going around with Coach.
Seven or eight times.
Quite a few.
Yeah, I had 3 different high schools. I moved around a lot of bit. Mm-hmm. Everybody asked me, they're like, well, how was that growing up? Or they asked me if I was military. I'm like, no, just coach's son.
Coach's son.
He's got to go where the job at, and I've loved it. Every single move that we made has always been a family decision. Mm-hmm. He's always come to us. He said, I won't take it if you guys say no. And even my senior mm-hmm. year, he comes to me. He's like, I will not move you from Florida, of all places, mm-hmm. away from Orlando, away from your friends, away from a starting spot at my high school I was at. And I said, hey, why not?
Go through it. There. Mike, when you step, go through his hip to him now. You step, he slants. You still got a step slant hit. Dog it. Here we go.
Hey, tall guy, get right here. All right, you're going to zone read that. You're going to pull it. You know, I really hate how tall you are.
Let's go.
Oh, gosh, that's even better. Hey, zone that. Now.
What's your best yard that you ball playing yard you can remember? Or a terrible one?
Probably when he was the head coach at Stephen F. Austin. It wasn't our yard. It was the field. I always played on the field. And one time we were playing Sam Houston. There's probably a picture somewhere. He let me run out with the team. And that was probably
game day?
Yeah, that was probably my best memory of just playing yard or something like that. That was probably.
How old were you, think?
Golly, how was that?
10?
I said 10 or 11.
So you were just coming up to guys' rib cages.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Atta boy.
He beat us all out there.
Yeah, I was first.
Is it hard being a coach's son? Has there been hard being a coach's son?
It's there's a lot of enjoyable things. I mean, some things I know at different levels is different. You're in the spotlight sometimes with the media, and you got to be careful what you do. I think it's always been a great experience for me. I mean, I've been able to go watch unbelievable football games. Obviously, I've taken this career up in coaching, and I wouldn't change a thing.
The floss, that's it. I don't know how to do the floss.
Play with your eyes. Keep playing with your eyes. Let's go again.
Good hustle. A lot of energy. A lot of energy. Get over there.
When you hear somebody say something about your dad, oh, I can't believe they ran the ball there. I can't believe they passed the ball there or something. Do you just want to just...
When they're in the stands when I was younger, it used to make me mad. But then sometimes I'd be like, I agree with you.
Keep going. Hey, y'all go in the right direction. I want y'all to go. Keep it going.
I like it, CT. That's how you hustle down there, baby. Hey, guess what? 24 hours, we're in the air.
What's the best advice you've given him, or some solid advice when he came to you and said, I think I want to do this?
You know, he grew up around it, so yeah. He knew it and everything. And then I think what I told him as a guy, you know, once he started, I didn't let him play football for the longest. And so when I finally let him play, and when we made those moves, I always told him, you always respect certain people on every team that you're with. And I said, you always tell me, and I tell him after basically every move we make, who are the 2-3 guys you respected on that team? Why? And it wasn't always the stars. It was guys that just worked hard or were strong Christian beliefs and displayed that at times and showed leadership in different ways. And I said, you need to keep those qualities that you enjoy in those people. Every time you make this move, you bring those with you and you start doing that at the next place you're at. And then that next place, you meet those people and you meet more qualities and do that. And I've kind of given them that in coaching too. I said, you're in coaching now. I said, always sit there and look at the coaches on all sides of the ball, not just Coach Baker that you work with, but look at the things they do. Respect, you'll see things you like, things you'll pull out of it. And for you, when you make your next move, you'll grab some of those things, either how they handle players, how they do things on the field, from everything. And so I said, always sit there. And he's really a lot better than I am as far as taking notes or writing things down or organizational things. As I always tell him, I said, the thing I'm so proud of is he's been at 3 different places, 3 different levels of ball, from high school, junior college, and college, and was elected a team captain at all 3. That's hard to do. You have to do certain things to do that. Not necessarily being a great player, but he did in other ways. I think he learned that through the moves.
And a lot of that goes to credit goes to Ms. Pam, too.
All of it.
Here we go. Dog, 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 dog. Here we go. Second line, next play.
What's the dynamic of father-son when y'all are cut? Is it like you thought it'd be?
Well, right now it's interesting. So usually, like, he coached me at junior college at Colin. So it was, we're always coming home talking about the game plan and talking about what we wanted to do and talking about different routes. And now that I'm on defense, he's on offense. During fall camp, it was kind of fun coming home and be like, man, we got after y'all today.
I'm going to interject there, Teddy, on that right there, because, you know, you make mistakes when you're a young coach. So he made some mistakes. And so, granted, one day they had a really good day. And it was at practice. And, oh, he couldn't talk smack all the way home. I laughed at him. I said, all right. Well, the next day just flipped like it does in this game. Mm-hmm. And the next day I looked at him and he didn't want to even look at me. And I was like, uh-huh. I said, lesson learned.
What I like about it is that if I ever need advice, you know, sometimes you, during the day, you don't have that time. You know, you don't have time to go up to Coach Baker, especially if he's doing something, to be like, hey, what do you think I should do here with a player or something like that? Like, he's got other things to worry about. And good thing about him is I could call him, I can see him later and ask what would he do in that situation that he may have faced in the past. And that's really helped me grow as a coach.
Get on that line, get on that line.
Dab, 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 settle. Now cut him, good.
Plus, I guess you've always, you know, you got one safe place to go all the time with this guy, no matter what the question is.
Absolutely.
All right, let me ask you a couple more things and we'll get you to practice. Ashley is your sister.
Yes, sir.
How much older is she than you?
Five years.
Okay. Did y'all get along growing up?
We did. Like, we never had the conflict of she was a senior and I was a freshman, right. So she had to, like, move away from me. So we were always been close. We're close now. I mean, we call each other every day, right. My little nieces.
So she's, because y'all got grandkids.
Yeah, got granddaughter. Fixed to have a grandson here in January.
Okay, good for y'all. And your birthday is January 1st.
I'm New Year's baby.
So don't forget.
Yeah.
Bend your knees. Don't get your feet spread and you're standing straight up. He's going to flip you on your back.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Ah! Hey, good D.
Hawaii Bowl. So don't like how it finished the season. So what do you feel like? I know you've been on the road recruiting and all, but what's the general feel? Is the team look this as an opportunity to go out strong? And,
you know, I think one thing, the way Coach Holtz kind of organizes these practices, obviously they're getting used to the new quarter academically, getting that going on. But weekends we work. And I've been very – the excitement of the guys working again, being around each other, they realize how fast this game goes. Season's over with.
Yeah.
And they realize, hey, these weekends we're getting three practices and pretty soon that's going to be gone, especially the seniors and all that stuff. But even some of the younger guys, they're excited about it, and the enthusiasm they're showing out there. Practice has really been good, focus. And so we're looking forward to these next 3 days before we take off for Hawaii. But I think the one thing is Coach does a good job of how he paces them, but we get the work in. And he understands, hey, guys, this is a big work weekend, and the guys, they're ready for it. They know it's coming, and they're prepared for it. So we're looking forward to a good weekend now and then getting out there and touching things up there at the bowl game.
Yeah, I know the Hannah Shipleys and Michael Rodriguez's of the world that I've talked to, they're so angry. They just want to go play.
Yeah, they're ready to go.
And this is a great, great gift for everybody. Speaking of, what do you want for Christmas? And we'll shut it down.
I want to win in Hawaii. That's my biggest wish. That's the only thing I want, really. And my nephew to be born healthy.
You want anything? Or are we at the age now where we're just being vertical?
You know, obviously, yeah. Every day, and just you know, just a great bowl victory and just a great time with these seniors and the team out there. You know, like I said, the way it finished, you don't like that to finish like that. We definitely don't want to go in the off season with that going into next year when we come in back in for January for practice for next year. But just a great time, just enjoying all the coaches and the players and all that together. Just a great safe trip there and safe trip back, and then obviously looking forward to a post gift with the birth of our grandson.
It'll be fun. Well, I'll be back on the 23rd, Lord willing.
Yeah.
Robert McFarland representing the offense, Coy McFarland representing defense. Y'all shake hands and let's go have a good practice.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Go Dogs.
Milikilikimaka is the way to say have a Merry Christmas the Hawaiian way.